To your daily grace inspiration message on feeding on Jesus. Today's Bible verse for meditation is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses 1 and 2. And the word reads, "The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has set me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives, and release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of God, of our God, to comfort all who mourn." Amen. The theme for reflection is, "I'm set free." Amen. A big amen to that. Brethren, what we are experiencing in the world today is not the day of vengeance, as described in Isaiah 61 verses 1 and 2. How do we know this? Jesus did say there will be pestilences and plagues, but the end is not here yet. What we are seeing now are just signs that we are living in the end times. In this time, don't refuse the voice of grace. The word of judgment is not the word of season right now. Hear the good news of grace. That is God's word for you today. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 reads, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Yes, this is the voice of grace. The voice of grace says, "Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." In grace says, "I died for your sins." Grace says to you, "I love you." Grace says, the voice of grace is, "I died for your sins." The voice of grace says, "Your sins are all forgiven." And the voice of grace says, I love you so much. Brethren, in those darkest season of the world, see that you keep hearing the voice of grace, which speaks salvation, voice of grace, which speaks righteousness, voice of grace, which speaks protection, which speaks deliverance, voice of grace, which speaks provision, which is the good news of our lives. I also encourage preachers and Bible teachers not to use the fear of judgment to try to I charge preachers, Bible leaders, not to use fears to preach holiness in their congregations. Speak the voice of grace. Speak the voice of the blood of Jesus that speaks forgiveness, provision, supply, and protection. Amen. We are still under the dispensation of grace, brethren. We are not in the day of vengeance yet. All the things mentioned in days of vengeance in the book of Revelation will happen after we have been raptured, caught up in the air with Jesus. We are looking forward to that. The fear of the Lord is important, but Jesus himself defined it as worship of the Lord. See Matthew chapter 4 verse 10. Not fear of judgment from God. Brethren, true holiness is produced when you know that you are loved by God and that God sent his son to die for your sins. that the work of Christ on the cross is a complete and perfect work, that you are no longer facing wrath because it has been put behind you by Christ. Now you are highly favored brethren in Christ. This security and powerful identity produces through holiness. For the believer, all wrath has been removed from your future. It's all been put behind you by the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ. Brethren, amen to the word, you are set free. Whom the Son set free is set free indeed. If Jesus sets you free, you are set free eternally. Nothing can change your freedom that Jesus purchased for you at the cross. Nothing can change the eternal forgiveness you have in his blood for you. If you truly accept him as your personal savior, you are set free indeed. Amen, brethren. Stay tuned. Share this link, share this video, and send through your any concerns you have on this darkest hours of ours, in this darkest time of ours. Send through your prayer requests and your birthday celebrations. There are two links at the foot of this video. One is the email address to send through your requests, and the second one is the website for Feeding on Jesus. Any video you missed, any teaching you missed on Facebook or YouTube, there is a link there. When you click on About a Home, just click on the YouTube or the Facebook link and you can retrieve all the sermons, the teachings you missed. Stay blessed. Shalom. Shalom. Bye-bye.